you're welcome back to my channel. Like you all know, wedding planning can be so stressful. The next couple of series, I'll be taking you through a guide on how to plan your wedding successfully. Stay tuned.
My name is Asitonka Agri Abba, and channel is called Asi Darling because I'm such a darling.
My name is Asi Darling and you're welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, consider subscribing, give us a thumbs up. The first thing I need to tell you today, we're talking about engagement. Newly engaged, yay! Congratulations, you just got the ring, and now I'm taking you through the top 6 tips you need to know now that you're engaged. The first thing you need to do is to announce. Now you have the ring, you call up your friends, call up your family, tell everybody, hey, I said yes. Post on social media, you're happy. So everybody needs to know your wedding is coming up. The first one, announce. So the next thing you need to do after announcing is to pick a date. And one thing you need to know, there are many factors that go into picking your date. If you're in Africa, talking about Nigeria, the next thing we're looking at is your introduction date. That is the major factor that gets into picking your main wedding date. So you're fixing the first thing, your intro date. His family has to come and officially inform your family about their intentions to take their daughter. So it's very important. The next thing for us is the introduction date. You plan for your intro. Of course, we are going to have subsequent videos telling you all you need to know about that. The next thing that has an effect, the next factor that has an effect on your date is the church. If you're getting married in the church, or like most religious bodies, they need information like 3 months, 2 months before. Some churches have counseling, very strict counseling. So if you're just engaged in March, you can't get married in May, or you can't get married in June, because probably your counseling section is 6 months. Some churches have 3 months, and it's so strict. So it depends on your church. That also has a factor if you're planning your wedding in that church. Another thing that has a factor in your event planning is the season. What season are you using? What season? What date? What period? So you can't just pick a period where the entire family is not free, or the entire family is not going to be able to attend. So that is an important factor. Like, when are you having this wedding? You have that date at the back of your mind way before the intro. Of course, that's the date you tell them at the introduction. But you also want a date that works best for everyone, which is very important. So the third one is to pick a location. A location, where would you be having your wedding? Would you be having your wedding in the east, the north, the south, or the west? If you're in Nigeria, you need to know, okay, where am I having my wedding? Is it Lagos, Abuja, Port Harcourt, Warri, Benin, Onitsha? Anywhere you need to have your wedding, the next thing, location is very, very important. That's the third thing you need to think of. Location, location, location. Okay, so the fourth thing you need to know is the budget. It is very important. Most times it's discussed during the introduction. The families begin to ask who's paying for what and how we're organizing this. Some traditions don't allow that. Some allow it. So your budget is very important. As a couple, you come together and you know who is paying for what, who is handling what. This is very instrumental to your wedding planning process, and you want to know where the monies are coming from. That is key. Money. And one thing you need to know, my next video will be telling you all the steps and tips you need to know about planning your budget properly. So budget is the fourth tip in this wedding planning. So the fifth thing is the number of guests, the guest size. How many people are you expecting for your wedding? Do you want it small and intimate, or do you want a large event? It's very important for you to get to this point, because the guest size is instrumental to your budget. Planning a wedding for 1,000 people is different from planning a wedding for 20, 50 people. So the finance is a big deal when it comes to the guest size. So how many people are you planning to have at your wedding? Also, be realistic. If you come from very big families, it's also a possibility that they are all going to want to come. So saying you want a wedding for 50 people might not be reality, especially when you're from Nigeria. So you need to know about the guest size. You need to have asked that during your introduction. Bring it up. Let both families hear. Mommy, daddy, I'm looking at 50, I'm looking at 200, I'm looking at 500. Then we get to a conclusion. This is very important, as this can also snowball into your budget. You tell them all the tips. Of course, introduction here is very popular and really important. And it's at the introduction you can settle on the guest size
for you.
So the last tip you need to know is to call a wedding planner. Okay, shameless plug, Carlos 3003 Events, fantastic brand. So you call a wedding planner and have them know these things that you have said. Okay, my name is, for example, my name is Mary. I'm getting married on June 3rd. I'm wedding in Port Harcourt. So this is an example. So when you call your wedding planner, you want to tell them your name, your date, your guest size, your location. Very, very important before you get into your brief. So now that you know all these things, call an event planner, book a consultation section, tell your wedding planner your things, vibe. It's all about vibe. If you want to choose a wedding planner, be sure that it's somebody you like, someone you want to be around. So vibe is very, very important. Number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, six tips you need to know about wedding planning. This is my channel again, Asi Darling. Please subscribe, give us a like, tell us, give us a thumbs up, click the notification bell. We'd love to hear from you. And check out the next video where we talk about the things you need to know before you plan your wedding. Now you're engaged, you have gotten all these tips. Before you get the next step, these are very vital things you need to know. Check out the next video linked below. I'll see you next time.